This is what I pray for you, and this is what I pray for me. This is not a religious thing. This is a life thing, a lifestyle. I believe that God wants to pull us from all of our works, and he wants us to enter into a rest, something that you and I talked earlier about, Ken. I think God wants us to enter into a rest, but we're so busy working. And the truth of the matter is, listen, a lot of times we're good at our work. Okay, we're good. We're gonna ascend that mountain and die there, though, okay? I know you're good, but there's something better. And I know you can handle 100 different things at one time. I know you can, but you still get tired. God doesn't want you to handle 100 things. He doesn't. It's like the Mary Martha thing, you know? He doesn't want you to handle 100 things. And I think that God has a rest for me and a rest for you that we have not yet entered into because we don't believe in it. We believe that our works is what produces things, not my rest. I got to work. I know you're good at it, and so am I. But there's something more powerful than my works. You know what I'm talking about, right? I know we're all great at what we do. Taking care of our jobs, our families, all the life situations, all the things that go on in our families. We can fix everything. We control everything. We can do everything. I know you're pretty good. But God wants you, but there's no rest there. There's no rest. There's no real peace there. And the difference between Moses and Christ, because the comparison there is the end. The difference between Moses and Christ is the same difference between a servant and a son in the house. You see, the servant, everything he does to get something. He gets a paycheck, he gets a meal, he gets a bed. The servant does a lot of work, but he does it to get something. The son doesn't do it to get something. He already owns everything. And that's the difference between works and rest. Works is you being busy all day long because you think that you're going to get something from it. I'm going to get my paycheck. I'm going to get a fixed relationship. I'm going to get this or that. And that's the servant mentality. I got to get this all done because I get something when I get it done. That's what keeps you working and going and working. And in our minds, we're always counting and, you know, this plusing and minusing. And I got to get over here. I got to get that. I got to get over here. And if I don't do that, I won't get that. The servant mentality keeps you in a place of work. It'll wear you out. I know you're very good at it, but it takes a lot of your effort. But the position of a son, you do a lot of work, but it's not to get anything. You don't need anything from anybody. I don't need your money. I don't need your compliments. I don't need you to like me. You understand, right? I'm not doing this to get anything from you. This is me, and I'm almost all speaking on your behalf, okay? I don't need anything from anybody. You don't need anything from anybody. You already have everything. You already have God, the Father. You have his approval. You have his love. You have his acceptance. He's going to take care of you all the days of your life. Everything you do in life is not to get something. You need to take the position of the son, not the servant. The position of the son, I know the son does a lot, but it's not to get anything. He already owns everything. Amen. Amen. So when I go to work, once again, I mean, it's a big one, but I don't go to work for a paycheck. We got to stop. I know God's talking to us again and again. We got to stop counting. We're not going for a paycheck. You're going to work. But you go there because God wants you there. God will provide for you. But you know, the truth is God can provide for you. I know it's hard to hear, but you know, you don't have to work and God will provide for you. Listen, if you're a lazy person, you're not going to work anyway. So I'm not. If you're lazy, you're lazy. You want an excuse to be lazy, you'll find one, okay? Right? So I like, oh, okay, I don't got to work. Whatever. But you don't. It's a mind thing. It's a brain thing. It's a lifestyle that's here. And when you and I will finally realize that there's no pressure on my day, there's no pressure on my schedule, there's no pressure on my family, I will walk through this life. I'm speaking for you now, too. I will walk through my family. You will walk through your family. You'll walk through your relationships. You'll walk through your place of business, and you will heal, and you will do the works of God. But there's no pressure. It's not because you're going to get something. You already have something. You already have joy. You already have peace. You already see it in your family. You don't see division in your family. You don't see brokenness in your family. You see God. And you're just working it out and talking it out and walking it out. You don't see, I got to fix this broken relationship. No, you see a relationship that's fine. You see God. You see the finished work, everybody. You see the finished work. And we need to work from that place of the finished work, not the work that needs to be finished, because the work that needs to be finished is we got to strike that rock again, and it wasn't done. Can you understand that? Only by the revelation of the Holy Spirit can we understand that, you know? And it's because of our unbelief. Listen, the reason why I leave my place of rest and I enter into works is because of my unbelief. And I just don't believe that God's going to take care of me. I think I have to count. I have to work hard. At the end of the day, I got to squeeze that check out. I got to pay these bills. What a tormenting lifestyle. There's no faith in that life. There's no faith there. Every time you count your dollars and realize they don't add up, there's no faith there. There's no trust there. God wants to release us from this precious of life and realize that we're not doing to get something. We're just doing because we're sent from God. We're children of the Most High to go and do good throughout the earth. Right? There must be a people on the earth who know this. There must be a people on the earth just like Jesus Christ who are on this earth and know why they're on this earth. They know that everything is taken care of. They are on this earth to do good and to heal just like Jesus. We are on this earth to do good. To heal the sick, to raise the dead, to cast out demons. You don't have to actually put your hands on somebody and say, come out, you foul, evil spirit. You can cast out demons by relieving people of their fears and their torments and their sorrow. You know that. You can heal them with your words, your life, with your, oh my goodness, with you stop putting demands on everybody else because you're under the demand. You can heal them by just get off everybody's back, man. Stop putting pressure on everybody because you're an unbeliever. Stop squeezing everybody because you have no faith. I speak this for everyone in the house. Other people have to perform because we're not getting it done. That's Moses. He's got to ascend the mountain and die. And then let's end with the Mary Martha story. Remember the Mary Martha story, everybody? You know, Jesus came into the house and Martha's busy cooking the meal. Mary's laying at his feet. Martha assumed he was hungry. I don't even know, did she ask him? Maybe he wasn't even hungry. She assumed. Obviously, her assumption was wrong. Of course, he said, Martha, nope, you picked the wrong one. that's not the one. And we're busy doing many things, Moses. You're busy doing many things. And God says, why? I don't want you to do many things. I know you're proud because you can do many things. Yes, you're proud because you do many things. You tell everybody everything you do. I know. But God said, I didn't tell you to do many things. Can you be good at just one thing? Just be good at one thing. Just be good at one thing. Can you hear the voice of God and just respond to that? Say, God, what are we doing here? What are we doing now? Can you sit at the feet of Jesus? Can you be good at just one thing? Hearing and obeying. It is my will to do his will. I am here to do the will of my Father. Not my will. But thy will. Can you be good at just one thing? What does God want? What does God want? People of God, you are the people of God. Be good at one thing. Tell the world what God wants. Amen. All right, guys, that's the word of the Lord. God bless you. Why don't you all stand? Pastor Dad, if you'll close us. Praise the Lord.
He heard you the second time. Praise God. That's good. There's so much. The word never ceases to expand our understanding because that's what it does. It grows. I was talking with someone. I'm talking about how in Song of Solomon, God calls us a garden, that we are the garden. And he plants those seeds in us, his word. And you know it's going to prosper because he planted it. It's his garden. You are his garden. Trying to recall a couple of things you said. Will you embrace the change? That's what you said. Will you embrace the change? Because the word tells us we are going to be changed from glory to glory. Will you embrace it? You know, I was thinking my thought with Moses as God told him, ascend to the mountain and you will see it. Those click together for me. Do you want to ascend to see what God is doing in your life? Well, then rise up. Don't stay at the low level that you've been treading. Rise up. Usually people, when they float, they're on top. When they sink, they're on the bottom. Well, rise up. But he wants us to see what he is doing. Behold, see what I am doing. In fact, Isaiah 43:19 says, behold, I'm about to do a thing. Do a new thing. Well, do we want to rise up? Do we want to continue to climb? Sometimes people just get tired. I've done enough. I'm 188. I haven't done enough yet. I got to use that. It was good. I'm not done yet. I think Paul said that. I pray you say that because God is saying, you ain't seen nothing yet, to quote what I said. Because God is still doing a work. And he said, climb higher. Ascend. Ascend and you'll see it. Rise up. Will you embrace it? That was the question. Will you embrace the change? And one thing people don't like, especially people that are 188 years old, don't like to change. No, I love changing. I love changing. And I'm not what I was 5 years ago, yesterday. I'm different today. And I expect each of us to be different more and more, day by day, moment for moment, faith for faith. Praise God. Embrace the change. Ascend, and you will see it. Can we say amen? Father, we give you praise and glory, for you, my God, are our Lord and our rock. And you've said, rise up higher. I want you to see me more and more. The more you see of me, the more you will be like me. This is what I have purposed. So I pray, ascend. Ascend. Look higher. Go higher. Go higher. Don't get tired. We give you praise, Father, in Jesus' name. All of God's people said, amen. Amen. Amen.